There are 14 and a half million single people in Canada. That may make it seem like it should be easy to find a match. But you have to know where to look. This is Dana and Miles' first date. They found each other on a dating app.
So the guy that I matched up was the most normal person that I've met.
She seemed like a really great girl. And you know what? I took the chance. And in dating, it's all about taking that chance.
Ask around, and there are plenty of other online dating success stories.
It was just like, it was for jokes initially, but I have a current girlfriend who I met on Tinder.
Some even say they swipe their way to what they hope will be lifelong love.
We're getting married July 20th. Yeah, it's worked out really well.
From dating apps like Tinder that enable users to match based on things like proximity and pictures.
What if you never found your true soulmate?
To websites such as eHarmony that claim to sell a scientific approach to finding a compatible match. Dating services make up a big but increasingly crowded industry. In Canada, it's a $112 million business. In the U.S., it's $2.4 billion. Thousands of businesses and brands try to set themselves apart by targeting niche communities. Take Christian Mingle, J-Date, Farmers Only, Grindr, and Silver Singles.
Come on, let's go meet people.
Are these ones with you?
Yeah.
Or even Sniffer, a dating app for dog owners to meet other dog owners. Scott Darling is one of its founders.
There we go.
Darling says he's invested about $100,000 in the app so far.
Time-wise, can't even measure that. Sweat equity, a lot more.
We can also use the map view, so you can find people directly in your neighborhood.
The app only has a few thousand downloads so far, mostly in Toronto, Los Angeles, and San Francisco.
You know, you do see from the reaction of people when you tell them about this product, they like the idea and they join up. So it tells me that though it may be saturated, there still is opportunity.
On the surface, it may seem like Darling is going head-to-head with other unique products, but one massive company actually dominates. Match Group is the parent company of Match.com. It owns Tinder and in recent years bought OkCupid and Plenty of Fish. It says it controls dozens more, but doesn't openly disclose them all. Still, Match Group boasts that more than 7 million users pay for its services.
Hi, Jacqueline.
Hey.
How are you?
Good. Thanks for coming.
You're
Bruce
welcome.
Croxon helped pave the way for the rise of digital dating services.
At Lava Life by Phone, hundreds of singles in your area are...
In 1988, Croxon co-founded Lava Life. It used the technology of the time, voicemail.
For a long time, we had the market to ourselves. Technology was big, it was expensive. Very unlike the environment and technology today. If you gave me 2 smart programmers in 6 weeks and 1/50th of the capital, I could duplicate the Lava Life system today.
Croxon and the other founders sold in 2004 for $176 million.
In hindsight, it was the right time because the market was already getting very busy.
The market has become even more competitive, and failures are common. Like with most startups, according to Forbes, 90% of dating startups fail. With Lava Life behind him, Croxon now invests in other new digital companies. But he says he has no interest in the dating app world.
It is an industry that, to me, had its day. The only way to be good at it is to be very, very large. Which is why when I see startup dating apps come through our door, I say, interesting, but no thanks.
There's no doubt it will be difficult for any startup to stand out at this point. But as long as Canadians continue to pay for the promise of finding a match online, there's still some hope for entrepreneurs who are also willing to lay it on the line for love. Jacqueline Hansen, CBC News, Toronto.
The concentration in the industry means that just a handful of major players control the data of tens of millions of people. People who, in more ways than one, open up their hearts to these apps. Their ages, faces, places they've been, education, race, religion, everything. Think that data is safe? Maybe not. In 2016, a researcher in Denmark developed a simple tool to get a random selection of profiles from 70,000 OkCupid users and released it publicly. Usernames, everything. Someone else grabbed 40,000 profile pics from Tinder to help educate an AI to recognize gender. And last year, security experts found vulnerabilities in several dating apps that allowed them to track users' locations, monitor their accounts, and send messages in their names. So good luck out there.